Hi, all of my beloved students. Today, I'm Sangmitra. We'll go through the fifth story, Indigo, from Flamingo of class 12. This story has been written by Louis Fisher, who was a notable American journalist. Among his works were a contribution to the ex-communist treatise, The God That Failed, A Life of Mahatma Gandhi, basis for the Academy Award-winning film Gandhi, as well as A Life of Lenin, which won the 1965 National Book Award in History and Biography. That renowned American journalist, Louis Fisher, was born on 29th February in 1896 in Philadelphia, United States, and was died on 15th January in 1970 at New Jersey in United States. For his works, he was awarded by National Book Award for History and Biography. He has written several non-fictional writings. Non-fictional means realistic based works he has written. Among his works, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi is the most important, as well as The Life of Lenin. And he had a slight interest in politics. So that's why he has written Men and Politics. And other important work is A Week with Gandhi. So this Indigo has been taken from the life of Mahatma Gandhi, what was happened in India that he described in this story. So let's discuss the introduction, summary of this story, and word meaning and question answers also. Let's see. In this chapter, Indigo, the main theme covered by the author is that how an effective leadership can overcome any problem. The chapter tells us about the leadership shown by Mahatma Gandhi to secure justice for the oppressed people through convincing argumentation and negotiation. Negotiation means discussion. Here you will see Mahatma Gandhi acts as a central character, and he protested against British, against the torture of British over the innocent people of innocent Indian people. There are several characters are in this story. I am explaining one by one. First character, Rajkumar Shukla, who is a peasant in Champaran and is troubled by the sharecropping system. He was illiterate but resolute. He never left Gandhiji's side until he agreed to visit Champaran. Next character, Gandhiji, who is the main and central character in this story, he visited Champaran on the request of Rajkumar Shukla. He spent almost a year of his life there. During his stay there, he removed the problems of sharecropping, and he contributed in the Indian independence struggle and also taught them self-reliance. Third character, Edward Gait. He was late governor of the province. He ordered to drop the case against Gandhiji. Later, as a result of his meetings with Gandhiji, an inquiry commission was set up to find out the problems. Next, Rajendra Prasad, who was a lawyer who later became the president of Indian National Congress and also of India. C.F. Andrews, he was an English pacifist and devoted follower of Gandhiji. He was ready to stay at Champaran and help Gandhiji, but Gandhiji opposed it. Sixth character, Kasturbai, who is the wife of Gandhiji, and she helped Gandhiji in this struggle against British. And last character is Gandhiji's son, whose name is Devdas. These are the major characters in this story. I am putting forth the summary in accordance with the happening of event. So first event, the idea of the departure of the British. Gandhiji tells Louis when the idea of the departure of the British came in his mind. It was in 1917. Gandhiji had gone to the December 1916 annual convention or meeting of the Indian National Convention of the Indian National Congress in Lucknow. A poor peasant came up to him. It was Rajkumar Shukla. He was from Champaran. He wanted him to come to his district. Gandhi had never heard of the place. It was near the kingdom of Nepal in Bihar. Shukla was a sharecropper. Shukla was resolute. Resolute means determined. Rajkumar Shukla was illiterate but resolute. He had come to the Congress session to complain against the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar. Gandhi had an appointment in Kanpur and had to go to other parts of India as well. Shukla accompanied him to the ashram in Ahmedabad. He begged Gandhi to fix a date. Gandhi was impressed with Shukla's determination. He asked Shukla to meet him in Calcutta and take him from there. In Calcutta, he waited till Gandhi was free. Then the two boarded a train for Patna. There, Shukla led him to the house of a lawyer named Rajendra Prasad, who later became President of India. But he was not there. In Muzaffarpur, Gandhi decided to go first to Muzaffarpur. He wanted to obtain more complete information about the condition of Champaran. Professor J.B. Kripalani waited for Gandhi at the station with a large body of students, a teacher in a government school. But he supported to Gandhi. Gandhi stayed for 2 days in the home of Professor Malkani. The news of Gandhi's arrival spread quickly through Muzaffarpur and then to Champaran. Sharecroppers from Champaran arrived on foot to meet their champion. Muzaffarpur lawyers called on Gandhi to brief him. Gandhi chided them for collecting huge fees from the poor sharecroppers. English landlords of Champaran. Most of the arable land in Champaran was owned by Englishmen. Indian tenants worked on the land. Germany had developed synthetic indigo. Now, indigo plantation was not very profitable. Therefore, they obtained agreements from the sharecroppers to pay to the landlords compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. According to the previous agreement, English landlords compelled all tenants to plant 15% of their land with indigo. They had to surrender the whole indigo crop to the landlords as rent. Those who opposed were tortured by their hired bullies. Meanwhile, the illiterate peasants saw through the trick of the landlords they were not ready to pay the compensation. Those who had signed wanted their money back. Gandhi received a summons to appear in court. Gandhi met the secretary of the British Landlords Association, but he didn't give him any information. Gandhi met the commissioner. He only warned him and advised him to leave the place. Gandhi didn't leave. He proceeded to Motihari, the capital of Champaran. A huge crowd greeted Gandhi at the station. Then he got an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. Gandhiji made it clear that he would disobey the order. So Gandhi received a summon or an order to appear in court the next day. All night, Gandhi remained awake. He prepared a full report to the Viceroy. The next morning, thousands of peasants demonstrated in support of Gandhi. It was the beginning of their liberation from the fear of the British. The officials felt helpless. Gandhi helped them to regulate, that means control, the crowd. The voice of conscience. The government was baffled, that means surprised. The authorities wanted to postpone the trial. Gandhi protested against the delay. Gandhi told the court that he was involved or caught in a conflict of duties. It was his duty not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker. On the other hand, he wanted to do justice to thousands of poor sharecroppers. He decided not to leave Champaran. Gandhi had full respect for lawful authority. But in the end, he heard the voice of his conscience. The court didn't deliver the judgments for several days. Meanwhile, Gandhi was allowed to stay in Champaran. Battle of Champaran. Own Rajendra Prasad and many other prominent or famous lawyers had arrived from Bihar. They supported to Gandhi. What would they do if Gandhi was sent to jail? The lawyers decided to follow him into jail. Gandhi exclaimed, "The Battle of Champaran is on." Several days after, the Lieutenant Governor of the province decided to listen to the case. Commission of Inquiry. Gandhi had 4 interviews with the Lieutenant Governor. He appointed an official commission of inquiry into the indigo sharecroppers situation. Gandhi was representative of the peasants or farmers. He remained in Champaran for more than 7 months. There were many evidences against the landlords and British officers. They had illegally extorted money, that means taken money from the sharecroppers. Gandhi demanded back for 50%. The planters or landlord offered to refund only 25%. Gandhi agreed because the British government first time bent down in Indian history. The deadlock was broken. Social work in Champaran. Gandhi saw the cultural and social backwardness in the Champaran villages. He wanted to do something about it immediately. Mahadev Desai and Narhari Parikh, 2 young men, joined Gandhi as disciples. Even their wives volunteered for the work. Many more came from Bombay, Pune, and other distant parts. Gandhi's son Devdash also joined them. Primary schools were opened in 6 villages. Kasturbai's wife of Gandhiji taught lessons of cleanliness and sanitation. Champaran episode, a turning point. The Champaran episode was a turning point in Gandhi's life. It was not a simple victory. It awakened the soul of the poor peasants. Gandhi tried to mold a new free Indian. He wanted to stand them in his own feet and thus make India free. Some people wanted C.F. Andrews to stay in Champaran and help them, but Gandhi opposed it. He didn't want that Indians should take the help of an Englishman in their own struggle for freedom. In this way, Gandhi taught them self-reliance or self-esteem. That is the summary of this full story.
We were both young when I first saw you. I closed my eyes and the flash flashback starts. I'm standing there on a balcony in summer.